ontmoet het. Vanuit die volle evangelie kerk groet ek jou in die kostbare naam van koning Jesus. Ek is so blij, jy is hier vanochtend. Baie dankie Enes, baie dankie Rachel, jylle het voorwaar voortreffelijk bedien vanmorgen. Soos altyd, ons waardeer vir jylle uit die dieptes van ons hart uit. Baie dankie. Mag God vir jou seën, terwyl ons na die tweede deel van ons reeks kyk, The Big Plan, maar vandag kyk ons na My Big Plan. Wat is jou plan vandag? Wat is jou plan vir 2021? Ons het laatst week afgesluit en ek het vir jou die hoogtepunte gegee wat my groot plan vir 2021 is en wat jou groot plan vir 2021 miskien kan word. Maar voordat ons doen, kom ons gaan na die Here toe en ons vraag vir sy seën vanmôre. Let's ask the blessings of the Lord on this meeting this morning. Thank you for being here. Here ons dankie vanmôre vir die wonderlike gawe van die Heilige Gees en dat ons in die dieptes van God in kan delf in die woord in en uit die woord uit 'n paar lesse kan leer vanmôre wat u vir ons instruktief wil gee vir hierdie jaar, wat u vir ons wil sê vir hierdie jaar en ek wil u bid Here dat u my maar net instrumenteel sal gebruik om u werktuig te wees in hierdie wêreld en hierdie gemeenskap in die kosbare naam van Jesus. Mag u verheerlik word Here. Baie dankie dat ons lofsang vanmôre u troonkamers kon bereik het en dat ons versoeke vanmôre by u sal kom in die kosbare naam van Jesus. Mag u verheerlik word in Jesus se wonderlike naam. Ons bid vir hulle wat miskien nie wel is vanmôre in die Here wat in hierdie gemeenskap en in ons koneksiegroepe is Here. Ons wil u bid in Jesus naam dat u hulle sal versterk, dat u hulle sal genees en restoreer. In Jesus naam dank ons u. Amen en amen. So loof die naam van die Here saam met my vanmôre geliefdes terwyl ons ook by wyse van ons offergawes en ons tiendes vir die Here se werk gaan bring. Baie keer dan dink ons klein ou gawetjie beteken niks, maar as jy in 2 Korintiërs 9 gaan lees, dan sal jy sien dat jou gawe baie beteken vir die Here. Baie dankie vir hulle wat al reeds hierdie bediening ondersteun het. Thank you for supporting this ministry by means of finance, by means of whatever the case might be, what you provide for this church and for this community, may the Lord bless you. Maar as jy nou gaan lees in 2 Korintiërs 9, dan staan iets opskrif, God gives most. God gee meeste. Ek gaan net 'n paar versies vir jou lees voordat ons diens begin vanmôre, die 6de vers. Now this I say, dis Paulus wat skryf vir gemeente van Korinthe. Now this I say, he who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly. And he who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. Each one must do just as he has proposed or purposed in his heart, not grudgingly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. Verse 10. Now he who supplies seed to the sower and bread for those for food will supply and multiply your seed for sowing and increase the harvest of your righteousness. Is dit nie mooi om te dink dat die Here vir ons 'n waarskuwing gee, vir my en vir jou. Hy sê, wie spaarsamiglik saai, sal ook spaarsamiglik maai. Dit maak net sin. As jy 5 saaitjies in die grond gooi, dan kan jy mos nou nie verwag om 20 saaitjies se opbrengste te kan lewer nie. Dit werk nie so nie. Enige saaitjie wat jy in die grond sit, gaan proporsioneel gee vir die saaier. Proporsioneel gee vir die saaier. So moet jy ook in jou hart en in jou lewe proporsioneel gee van jou inkomste vir die Here. Ons weet dat proporsioneel praat van baie dinge. Party mense glo dat jy 'n tiende deel gee soos ek glo ek moet 'n tiende deel bring vir die koninkrykswerk en ek doen dit elke maand. En so kan jy ook so betrokke raak iewers daar waar jy in die bediening betrokke is, daar waar jy miskien in 'n gemeente betrokke is om 10% van jou inkomste vir die werk van die Here te gee. Op so 'n wyse kan die werk van die Here dan voortgaan. Nou, vanmôre gaan ons uit ons dit wat ons het gaan ons bring vir die Here. En my gebed is dat die Here dit sal seën wat jy op jou hande bring vir hom vanmôre. In Jesus naam dank ons U vir die gawes. Ons dank U vir die seën op die gawes in die kosbare naam van Jesus. Amen. God bless you. Mag die Here in jou behoeftes ook voorsien. Ek gaan nie met jou lank wees nie want volgende week wil ek ook aangaan met hierdie onderwerp en dit is dan gaan ons weer terug na the big plan. Oké, okay, dan gaan ons vandag praat oor my big plan. Jy's ek wil sommer my skerm deel dat jy kan sien wat ek met jou gaan praat vandag. Jy mag miskien voel jy het 'n ander groot plan vir die nuwe jaar. Ek weet nie wat gaan nou aan met my skerm nie. Kom ons stop dit net gou vir eers. Dit lyk beter. Nou, jy gaan daar op die bord sien dat dit is my groot plan vir 2021. Ons het laas week met hierdie slide afgesluit. Nou gaan ons net voort met die volgende slides. En ons het gesê dat slegte gewoontes, jy weet, moeilik doodgaan of moeilik kan verdwyn. Bad habits die hard, Dis wat ons gesê het. En ons het ook gesê, but good habits die easily. En dis die probleem wat ons agtergekom het gedurende hierdie lockdowns en so meer, is dat goeie gewoontes maklik gesterf het in hierdie tyd. Maar slegte gewoontes het baie maklik opgekom. Our problem is that we do not put our faith in the things that really matters for the kingdom's sake and for us as human beings. Ons plaas ons geloof in dingetjies wat nie regtig saak maak nie. Vaardige mense onthou dan. Jy klim op die vliegtuig en wanneer jy op die vliegtuig klim, dan vertrou jy die loods. You trust the pilot on the airplane more than you trust God. Because as soon as I tell you, you should trust God in the most difficult times of your life, then you would want evidence. You want proof that you can trust God. But when you get in on an airplane, you do not need the papers of the pilot. You do not ask the papers of the pilot and the co-pilot. Jy vra nie vir die papiere en sê, hey, waar is jou license? Bring 'n bietjie jou license, dat ek jou license kan sien om te sien of jy werklik waar geskik is om hierdie groot area te vlieg. Nee, jy doen nie dit nie. So ons plaas ons geloof baie makliker in mense as wat ons geloof op die regte dinge en in God stel. En hierdie jaar vir my as persoon wil ek seker maak ek sit my geloof nie in mense alleen nie, maar ook in God, die lewendige God. Want as jy God eerste stel, if you put God first and you put him first above all, give him first, love him first, talk to him first, let him be first in your life. Relying on Jesus is the only way to put God first. There's no other way to put God first but to rely upon Jesus. When you can rely upon Jesus and fall back in faith on him and into his lap, jy dag gaan die Here jou surprise. You will get a surprise from the Lord every time you wake up in the morning. So vanoggend gaan ek verder en ons gelees uit die boek van Jesaja. Jesaja 43. En ons gaan 'n hele paar versies lees, maar ons gaan stil staan by hierdie 18de en die 19de vers net vir so 1 minuut of so. Ek gaan net gou kyk of ek vir jou my Jesaja gedeelte kan opsit hierso. Ek gaan hom sommer so oortrek, dan kan jy saam met my lees. Ek het die Afrikaans hierdie kant gesit. And God is talking to the redeemed. There is obviously Israel the redeemed, but for us now as the church, he's speaking to us, he's speaking to our hearts this morning through his holy word. The Bible teaches and he says, but now thus says the Lord, your creator, O Jacob, and he who formed you, O Israel, do not fear, for I have redeemed you, I have called you by name, you are mine. Can you say this morning that God has truly called you by your name? Maybe God has given you a new name, I don't know. Maybe God has given you a new personality, I don't know, I really hope so. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. This I want just to put a small note on this. You should make this as your commitment that God has made a promise to you that he will be with you through the waters and through the rivers. So if it's not through the waters, he will be with you through the rivers. That's what he promised. And they will not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be scorched, nor will the flame burn you. Can you see what happens here? Die Here vat jou deur die waters, hy vat jou deur die riviere, hy vat jou ook deur die vuur. Met ander woorde, van een seisoen na die volgende sal hy jou neem. From one season to the next, God will lead you through the waters, the sea, watery season, he will lead you through the rivery season, and he will lead you through the fiery season. Trust him in that. For I am the Lord, your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. I have given Egypt as your ransom, Cush and Seba in your place. Since you are precious in my sight, since you are honored and I love you, I will give other men in your place and other peoples in exchange for your life. Isn't that amazing? That God has made the solemn promise to Israel and to his beloved church that he will give others in your place because he loves us so much. Do not fear, for I am with you. I will bring your offspring from the east and gather them from the west. Verse 7, everyone who is called by my name and whom I have created for my glory, whom I have formed, even whom I have made. Did you hear that? So this promise is for everyone who's called by his name. Isn't that amazing to know that he will lead you through the watery season, the rivery season, as well as the fiery season. And he made this promise and he said, everyone who is called by my name, he will do it for us. Now, let me just go to verse 10. You are my witness, declares the Lord, as my servant whom I have chosen, so that you may know and believe me and understand that I am he. Before me there was no God formed, and there will be none after me. I even, I am the Lord, and there is no Savior besides me. God has said this, and I believe it. There's no one besides God that can save. Selfs die boek van Handelinge 4 vers 12 praat van, daar is geen ander naam gegee onder die mense, waardeur ons gered sal word nie. It is I who have declared and saved and proclaimed, and there was no strange God among you. And then you can just go and read on by yourself, but this is now the portion that speaks about Babylon destroyed because of the children of Israel, because God wanted to bring them back from Babylon. But listen now what the verse 18 says, and this will also be our, the portion of scripture we'll be sharing with you this morning, and that is the 18th and the 19th verse. Do not call to mind the former things, or ponder things of the past. And that, we can do that all too well. Ons kan nogal vaststeek op die verlede, te makkelijk. And I say, behold, I will do something new. Now God is declaring this over your life this morning, that 2020 has passed. Do not ponder on 2020 or 2029, COVID-19 or COVID-20, whatever the case may be for us this year, COVID-2021, I don't know. But the fact is, God is saying to us, do not ponder on these things. Behold, I will do something new. God is going to do something new for you. Now it will spring forth. Will you not be aware of it? En hy vra, gaan jy nie, maak 'n bietjie hoop, kyk en sien wat God besig is om te doen in hierdie wêreld. Kom ons word wakker as kinders van die Here, en ons begin oor mekaar die Here se naam roep, kom ons begin God se naam te prys. En hy sê, I will even make a roadway in the wilderness, rivers in the desert. In other words, whatever the dry seasons may bring, he will help us, he will sustain us, he will care for us. No matter what happens in our lives, he will care for us. So now let's look at my big plan for 2021, from taking me from 2020 to 2021. Most importantly, people, you will take other people. Jy gaan ander mense neem. What can you take with you? What can you leave behind? I'm sure you want to leave the taxman behind. Jy gaan die taxpersoon achter wil los in 2020 en nie jou opgave is hierdie jaar teen Februarie doen nie. Jy gaan graag daai dinge wil achterlos. Jy gaan baie ander dinge wil achterlos, die pyn van die verlede. Daar was 'n man gewees, Pastor Rikkie Steyn, hy het hierdie grapje vir ons al vertel, vir so 1 of 2 keer, die story wat hy vir ons vertel het in Israel, op ons besoeke daar. Hy sê, daar kom 'n man in Israel aan, en die taxi-driver vat hom, die taxi-driver vraag van, waar toe wil jy gaan, where do you want to go, sir? And the taxi driver, well, the man, the response there in Israel, he says, I want to go to the Wailing Wall. He said, the Wailing Wall? What the heck is the Wailing Wall? And whilst they were driving, the man tried to explain to him, and he said, man, that wall, what do you call it? The quartet, that wall. He said, the quartet. Now, this Arabic person doesn't know this wall exactly, but he was unsure about which wall this person was talking about. And as they were driving, he said, but explain to me a bit more. He said, man, there were the Jews crying. Oh, okay. And they drove, and he took him to the tax office of Israel. So yes, it may be your tax. It may be something else you want to leave behind. It may be your wife, but don't leave her behind. It may be your children, but don't leave them behind, because these are the only people you can carry to forward. Most importantly, you should carry people towards 2021. Jy moet mense in 2021 invat. Dit sal nie lekker gewees om die toekoms te kon sien nie, en wat 2021 vir ons tog inhou nie. Dit sal nie lekker wees om dit te kan sien nie, want hoekom wil ons dit tog sien? Ek ben baie mense wil graag die toekoms sien, maar ek en jy is nie mense wat die toekoms wil sien nie. Ons sal dit dag vir dag vat. Dit maar aan jou planne vir 2020, roep het een bykie uit en tot gedachtenis. Bring het gauw vinnig tot gedachtenis en dink waarin het jy gedink in 2020 vir 2021 of selfs van 2019 na 2020 toe. Jy het miskien baie mooi ideale gehad en so meer. Jy het speciale verhouding met sekere mense gebou in 2020 wat jy graag wil saamneem in 2021 in. Is mense met wie jy saam geëet het. Een goeie ding wat lockdowns vir ons geleer het, is om bykie saam by die tafel te sit en laat ons saam te eet, man. Miskien het jy dit geleer, en maybe you have taught yourself again to eat with your family at the table. and praising the Lord with them at the table. Some others have brought other relationships from 2021, from 20 to 2021. Those relationships that can cause devastation in your life. Break off those relationships. Moenie hulle saamvat in 2021 in nie. There was a guy, his name was Boyce. He's a theologian. You can Google him. He's already deceased. But he said these words: if we want other people to praise God, we must praise God first. If we want them to love God, we must love Him too. If we want others to serve God, we must serve Him. We must set an example. We must set an example, people, of how to serve the Lord, how to praise the Lord. We must be that example. What I also can take from 20 to 21 is skills I've learned. Skills I've learned. Many of you have learned different skills. Baie van julle het hierdie fantastiese gawes geleer in 2020. Baie van julle het miskien ingeskryf vir 'n graad. Lockdowns het jou dalk vervelig gemaak en jy het gedink, kom ek gaan kyk online, wat kan ek studeer? Baie mense het hulle meesters begin, ander mense het doktorale begin. Maar die feit bly staan is, you started to study during the lockdowns, you started to study in 2020 to take it to 2021. You should just go on with that. Ander het net rondgesit en gewag vir iets om te gebeur en hulle gaan nog steeds rondsit in 2021 op Netflix kyk, wat kan hulle daar kyk? Maar ek en jy is nie daai tipe mense nie. Ons is mense wat go-getters is. Ons gaan uit en ons gaan soek iets om te doen. So dis die tipe goed wat jy graag van 2021 wil inbring. So wat bring jy nog saam? Jy beplanning en maniere van besparings. Ek meen ons het geleer hier in ons huis mense om te bespaar, om in maniere te kry hoe om te bespaar en so meer. 2020 het ons geleer om dit te doen, selfs 2019. En dis een van die gewoontetjies wat ek graag in 2021 wil inneem. En dis nog om steeds te bespaar. Nog steeds om nie na die skuld gewers te hardklop en skuld te gaan maak nie, maar om die Here te vertrou en te bespaar. En geld te bespaar natuurlik. Last but not least, bring the presence of God with you into 2021. And that is the only unchangeable thing you can bring in to 2021. There's so many changeable and adaptable things you can bring from 2020 to 2021, but the only consistent is the Lord God Almighty. With the presence of God, it also comes with the word of truth. The word of truth comes with God. When you bring in God in 2021, the truth comes with you. The invertible truth, you cannot change the truth. The unchangeable truth, Bible tools, you can bring that in to 2021. How you study the Bible. Baie van julle het saam met my begin Bybelstudie doen in die oggende. En elke ek die ander dag toe vra tannie Hendret, hoekom het ek nog nie weer 'n nuwe stukkie geplaas nie toe? Môre sal ons met 'n stukkie begin wat 21 dae gaan neem. As jy nie betrokke raak by daardie stukkies nie, dan gaan jy net ledig rondsit in 21. Ek en jy is nie daai mense nie. Ons moet ons gebedstyd in 2021 inneem. Ons moet ons prayer time, ons Bybelstudie tye in 2021 inneem. We need to bring our trust into 21. We need to bring our hope in 21. The Bible teaches in Hebrews 13:8. It says Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forevermore. He is the unchangeable Lord. Praise his wonderful name. But the second thing we bring into 2021, it's a revolution. It's not a resolution. Sometimes we want to make resolutions, but resolutions doesn't stand. Revolution stands. And change is good sometimes, but people revolt for all the wrong reasons most of the time. They revolt for the wrong reasons, and it pains my heart to see the world going up in flames because people are revolting for all the wrong things in this world. They revolt for sexual equality. They revolt for taking out the Bible out of the schools. They scream and yell at you when you speak the truth against them. Or they say you are a hater when you preach, for example, against homosexuality and that you should keep the marriage sane and that you should keep the marriage holy. They hate the weirdness of us. And we do not speak about the weirdness. But the thing is that people revolt for the wrong reasons. Wrong reasons. Psalms 21:11 says, though they intended evil against you and devised a plot, they will not succeed. They will not succeed. Just believe this for 21, that they will not succeed. They've intended it. They've intended evil against you. They've devised a plot against you, but they will not succeed because God is your protector. God will lead you. He will guide you. And he will make you strong against the evil that will be standing up against us in 21. Spurgeon said this words. He says, intentional evil has a virus in which is not found in sins of ignorance. Listen now. This is not I who speaks. It's Spurgeon, the great theologian of the 1800s. He said intentional evil has a virus in it. Now, we are living in Corona times. There is intentional evil in that also, in which is not found in sins of ignorance. Now, as ungodly men with malice, a forethought, you can maybe use another word like planned or calculated attack, the gospel of Christ, their crime is great. So in other words, the Bible teaches if they attack the word of God, if they attack the gospel of Christ, well, Spurgeon says, their crime is great and their punishment will be proportionate to their attack. Now, if the people out there attacks you and the Bible-believing Christians, if people attacks us, the Bible, well, Spurgeon says, their punishment will be proportionate. Now, what I've seen, and I've seen this ugly thing, but I'll explain it in a bit. You'll probably know. Close your eyes if you're under 18, please. A time is coming when men will go mad. And when they see someone who is not mad, they will attack that person. They will attack them, saying, you are mad. You are not like us. This is St. Anthony the Great that said this. And we are living in that time where people who doesn't believe in vulgar stuff like this on the right side of the screen, they'll say, you're mad because you're not like us. We believe in this mad things. Now, the picture on the right, lifenews.com, they reported on this and they gave the photo on January the 5th. And it was breaking news at that stage. They said that the breaking news was that, and this is the reason why many people, they will go all out for feminism. But the breaking news on life.com of lifenews.hq.com was 45 abortion clinics was closed in 2020 and last year. 45. That means it's 79% of all abortion clinics open in 1991 have shut down, people. 79% of all abortion clinics are shut down. That's amazing. Now, this picture over here, this was erected by a lady called, what's her name again? I didn't put up her name, but anyhow, this is a feminist that created this. It's somewhere there in Europe. And this feminist, she erected this statue. This is a woman's part. I do not want to call it out the name even. It's a 33 meter long vagina. And it's a statue to promote the killing of more babies and abortions. This is one of the weirdest things I've ever seen in my whole life. I've never seen it. And what she says is, our bodies, our rules. Man, come on, this is ludicrous. It's crazy. It's crazy to think that we are living in such a crazy world to think that these things, it's okay. Therefore, St. Anthony the Great said, the time will come when men will go mad and when they see someone who is not mad. That man is not always angry, but he's also angry. They will attack him saying, why are you not so angry or why are you not so mad like us? A congressman in the United States, a congressman, his name is Emmanuel Cleaver. He is also a pastor. He did this week in the Senate opgestaan in the VSA and his gebed begin door the priestelijke seun uit te spreek in the Congress. And toe hy die gebed afsluit, to say, amen, a woman. Do you understand? He said, a man, a woman. That's how we concluded this prayer. Now, he got a lot of backslash. Mense het hom nogal sterk aangevat en te probeer hy nou verduidelik dat in last week het die Congres moes hulle besluit te maak en hulle wil het deurvoer en forceer die woordeboeke en so meer en die taal wat hulle gebruik binnen in die Congres verander. Hulle sal nie meer sê, they won't be saying chairman anymore, but they will say chairperson. They won't say mother and father anymore, but they'll say parents. in Congress. So, as jy op jou Facebookblad nou sê jy's 'n ma, dan is jy nie in lyn met dit wat hulle wil hê jy moet sê nie. Jy moet sê jy's 'n you're a parent. Jy's 'n ouer. Dis wat hulle wil hê jy moet sê. Kom aan mense, ons leef in Malta. En ons gaan 'n bietjie volgende week daaroor bietjie meer gesels. Ek raak nou te excited. Nou ja, we should revolt for the right reasons, people, in the season we're in. You cannot revolt for a season that's gone, but you should revolt for the season that is being that you're in. Trump revolted, the United States president, the 45th president of the United States, he revolted for the right reasons. And people hated him for that. I'm not preaching Trump now. I'm preaching the truth now. Yeah, well, for the he fought for the unborn children. He fought for the family. He fought for American jobs. But he got sacked or he got kicked out by the people. He got kicked out from Twitter, from Facebook, and all of these big tech companies. Because they want to control the whole world. And a person like him, he won't be controlled. Don't trust polls because they're just trolls. Remember this in 2021. Don't trust a poll because they're just trolls. Jy weet wat 'n troll is, iemand wat die hele dag agter jou aan troll. When you stand for the right things, the left's would want to crush you and your beliefs with their philosophies. Because the left, they do not have a Bible they can stand upon. We've got the word of God we can stand upon. A communist doesn't have a Bible because the communists will burn out all Bibles. But for us, standing with the word of God, we've got more than philosophy. We've got the word of truth, the word of the gospel of Jesus. The next gen should be protected, people, and they should be protected by us. We have failed them in 2020. We should protect the next gen. We should do it. And this year will be a year of protection for the next gen. Forget what's behind you. This is my second last point I want to mention today. Vergeet wat agter jou is. Dis die drie speelkie mentaliteit versus die windskerm mentaliteit. Ek is geleer om nie agter my te kyk terwyl ek bestuur, mense. Ek is ook geleer om nie agter my te kyk terwyl ek hardloop nie. My afrigter het altyd gesê, moenie agter jou kyk nie, jy verloor jou pas. Jy verloor jou pas, you lose your pacing when you always look behind you when you're a runner. Party ouens sê, my oë was nog nooit bou geslaan nie, want ek kyk hier agter toe as ek weghardloop vir my aanvallers nie. Mense weet wat 'n skade terugkyk doen. Ons weet wat 'n skade terugkyk doen in jou verhouding. Jy weet wat dit doen in jou verhouding wanneer jy die hele tyd terugkyk jou werk en jou lewe, maar nog steeds broer kyk jy terug in jou verlede in die hele tyd. En op die wyse verloor jy die seën van die Here. Jy loop oor die seën van die Here, jy sien dit nie eens raak nie, want jy kyk die hele tyd agter toe. Jy mis soms wat reg voor jou is. En val baie keer oor jou blessing wat voor jou gekom het en dan kom jy nie eens agter as 'n blessing nie, want dan is dit 'n stumbling block geraak vir jou. Jy val baie keer daaroor. Jy val oor geleenthede. Jy weet nie eers dis 'n geleentheid nie, want jy word in 'n verleentheid gedompel wat jy struikel oor iets wat voor jou is, want jy kyk die hele tyd agtertoe. If you keep on looking backwards and if you've got the rear view mirror mentality, then you'll fall over the opportunities. These opportunities will become a stumbling block for you. Watch out and be mindful of that. Die verlede kan tot op 'n punt vir jou goed wees, mense. Maar daarna kan dit nie meer vir jou goed wees nie, beweeg vorentoe. As jy uitwerking op die positief, as jy verlede positiewe uitwerking op jou het, natuurlik vat jy dit vorentoe. Maar los dit wat jou seer gemaak het agter. Nou soos ek weer gesê het vroeër, is dit jou vrou wat jou seer gemaak het in 2020, ekskuus daaroor, maar gaan vir counseling in 2021. As dit jou familie is, bring hulle vir counseling in 2021 na julle pastoor toe of so. 2 Korintiërs 5:17 sê, therefore if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creature. Hallelujah. I'm a new creature in Christ. The old things passed away. Behold, new things have come. When Jesus enters your life, new things has come into your life. And praise him. Give him glory right now where you sit. Hallelujah. Praise his wonderful name in this place. Jesus, thank you for allowing me to be a new creature. Praise God for that. Another scripture about that is 1 John 4, 20, 20 and 21. Nogal toevallig, ons preek vandag oor 20 en 21. If someone says, I love God and hates his brother, he's a liar. You are a liar if you hate other people. I'm not telling you should accept every philosophy out there of or every political stand or whatever the case may be. I'm talking about general love. I'm talking about agape love, a type of love God gave you, a kind of love God wants you to give to other people. For the one who does not love his brother whom he has seen cannot love God whom he has not seen. And this commandment we have from him, Jesus now, that the one who loves God should love his brother also. It's easy speaking about love. It's easy speaking about your feelings for the invisible God. But to truly live it out is another thing. It's easy to speak to somebody about God, but to truly live it out is another story. We see many spiritual dwarfs because the lack of love for others. Ons sien geestelike babetjies so baie in kerke en in die wêreld, oralste, oordat mense hulle is geestelike babetjies want hulle het nie lief nie. Cain offered God the fruits of his hands and not the fruit of his spirit or the spirit of God. The commandment we have from Jesus Christ who said, love one another. Dis die commandment, mense, dat ek en jy moet mekaar lief hê. Pyn van die verlede word net erger as jy dit net gaan koester die hele tyd. Wanneer jy die pyn die hele tyd koester van die verlede en dit saambring in 2021 in, dan gaan dit die hele tyd vir jou pla, dit gaan die hele tyd vir jou seer maak, dit gaan die hele tyd vir jou krap en dit gaan jou skade doen. Deel met die pyn, moet dit nie verwerp nie, ek meen jy kan dit nie verwerp nie, deel met die pyn. Deel met die smart siklus as jy verloor het en groot verliese gehad het. En dan gaan jy vorentoe. Daar is natuurlik mense wat hulle vreugde verloor het in 20. Daar's mense wat hulle vreugde verloor het en hulle hoop verloor het in die nasie. En ek wil jou vra dat jy jou hoop sal behou terwille van die een langs jou. Terwille van die een wat jou luister daar in die straat. Terwille van hulle wat vir jou omgee. Ek is regtig amper klaar. Hier is my laaste punt wat ek wil maak vandag. Voor ek afsluit rede gaan gee. Jesaja sê hoe ons in geloof moet wandel in 2021. In vers 3 in hoofstuk 11 sê, and he will delight in the fear of the Lord, and he will not judge by what his eyes see. Listen up, people. This is us. The Bible is speaking about us here. We will delight in the fear of the Lord, and he will not judge by what his eyes see, nor make a decision by what his ears hear. And that's the problem with us. We get our news from social media. We get our news from this and this and this person. Because we always judge by what our eyes see and what our ears hear. And that's not the way we walk in faith, people. We walk in faith even if we're blind and even if we are deaf. Kan ons nog steeds in die geloof wandel. Our problem is we do not put our faith in the things that really matters, as I've early stated. If you said you put God first, put him first. If you said today that you're gonna give him first, you're gonna love him first, do it then. Talk to him first. Let him be the first one in your life. Relying on Jesus, is that what you need? Kom dat ek en jy nie daai mense wees wat die vleenier meer vertrou as vir God nie. That we trust God more than we trust the pilot. You do not ask the pilot for his documents before you enter the airplane. But we need some clarification before we can trust the Lord. Why is that? God vertrou moet jou eerste prioriteit wees in hierdie jaar. Die Here gaan jou help. Die Here gaan jou bestuur om hom eerste te vertrou. Ek is klaar. En ek wil jou vra dat jy 21 sal omhels. That you will just embrace 21 in faith. That you will embrace 21 in geloof. Verwelkom elke seisoen hierdie jaar. Elke seisoen, want geloof in my, daar gaan seisoene wees. En elke jaar is daar nog seisoene, wat jy kan nie dit vryspring nie. Jy sal deel met elke situasie en elke seisoen. Jou situasie, Boeta, Sissa, jou seisoen, deel met dit. Jy gaan daarmee met deel. Jy dink miskien, jy is die swart skaapie in God se familie, jy is nie. Jy dink miskien, as ek dit kan uitstel, kan dit afgestel word. Dis is so maklik nie. Jy kan nie jou seisoen afstel nie, want jy moet in hierdie seisoen bly om sterker te word vir die volgende seisoen. Dit tel nie vir alles in die lewe van uitstel kom afstel nie. Dit sou lekker gewees het as jy 'n seisoen kon uitgestel het en net aangegaan het met jou lewe, maar jy moet daardeur beweeg. As jy byvoorbeeld uitstel om aan een of ander belangrike aspek in jou lewe of in jou huwelik te werk, dan gaan jy moet praat en jy sal moet glo dat dit sal regkom. Jou situasie is gekoppel met 'n klein ding draadjie wat aan die volgende situasie verbind is. Jy kan nie losmaak van hierdie situasie na die volgende situasie nie. Hulle is gekonnekteer. Partykeer is daar 'n brug tussen die een en die ander, maar hulle is gekonnekteer met mekaar. Omhels 2021, geliefdes. Wees jy die beste persoon vir jou kinders, vir jou vrou, vir jou gesin, vir almal wat vir jou lief is, en onthou, wees lief vir mense om jou. Moet mense nie verwerp nie, moet mense nie alleen laat staan nie. Hulle het jou nodig in hierdie seisoen. Hulle het jou nodig in hulle seisoen. God sit mense in jou lewe in elke seisoen om jou te kan help. In every season God will position people in your life. If you live for God, obviously, He will put people in your life that will be seasoned kind of people. People that's been there, has done that, has got the t-shirt. They will be seasoned for your season to assist you or to be co-pilots in your season to the next. So that you can overcome and be an overcomer in 21. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord make His face to shine upon you and be give you peace. And may the Lord make His countenance over you and let His countenance come over you and be gracious unto you. Mag die Here jou seën en behoed. Mag die Here sy aangesig oor jou laat skyn en jou genadig wees. Mag die Here sy aangesig oor jou verhef en jou ook vrede gee. Lord, we want to pray this morning and we want to thank you that we can come from 21 with a big plan to 21 to from 20 to 21 with Jesus, and that from that season to this season that we cannot be expired by one season because you are greater than the season itself. Here is groter as enige seisoen dat by die kan ek wil die bid vanoggend Here vir hulle wat my stem gehoor het dat U ons sal seën in Jesus naam, dat U ons sal toemaak, dat U ons sal help om in ons seisoen Here die beste te kan wees, die beste te kan doen vir die koninkryk van God. Thank you Lord Jesus for leading us from 20 to 21 and being the instruments and being the seasoned instruments for others in their specific seasons in the name of Jesus. So as jy hierdie gebed saam my gebid het en jy staan op vandag uit jou sitplek uit waar jy sit, waar jy miskien 'n koffietjie drink in 'n koffieshop en hierdie boodskap luister. Ek wil vir jou vra dat jy jouself sal oriënteer in jou gedagtes en in jou hart dat hierdie seisoen, hierdie jaar is God se jaar. Kom ons vertrou die Here dat hy sal terugkom. Kom ons hou aanbid vir mekaar, vir al die mense wat hulle lewens verloor het, se families. Daar's soveel mense, ons sal Woensdag aand weer vir hulle bid. Kom ons bid vir hierdie mense, vir die mense wat siek geraak het in die afgelope tyd. Kom ons bid vir hierdie mense dat die Here net sal restaurasie bring, herstel bring. Ek het gister saam met Pastor Benny hulle hier van die lede in Christus Kerk hier langsaan het ons by Pekelary gaan bid. Hulle bid vanaand weer en môre en oormôre en week in die week weer daarso en by ander plekke en ander hospitale 6 uur in die aand. Word betrokke, laat ons saam hande vat en God se naam kan roep oor ons nasie en oor ons wêreld. Ek weet nie wanneer gaan die dienste begin nie, geliefdes. Ek glo en vertrou dat dit seker spoedig sal begin en dat die Here vir ons sal help en seën en en miskien hopelik volgende Sondag ons sal u op hoogte hou. Ons sal u genoegsame tyd gee om gereed te maak om aan te trek vir die diens. Ons gaan moet wag vir die president sê en hoor wat hy sê. Ek is vol vertroue dat ons in ons nuwe kerk sal begin wanneer die dienste oopmaak. Die dak is op, alles is op. As nog een klein lekkie wat uitgesorteer moet word, voor die matte kan ingesit word. So ja, ons wag in spanning dat die Here vir ons sy openbaring sal gee en vir ons sal help. En wanneer ons weer begin, miskien volgende week, miskien die week daarna, by hang af van die presidentsie, dan gaan ons in ons gebou in, ons nuwe gebou of ons ou gebou wat amper net is. Mag die Here jou seën. Gaan geniet die week. En baie dankie vir jou bydraes en jou offers en alles. Ons waardeer dit uit die diepte van ons hart uit. Gaan jy wees die kerk. You go and be the church.